love, light, prosperity, hope, progression, love, support, strength, courage, wisdom, and everything positive that I can even think to put out. Just putting it out there to you guys. Peace to you. Peace. Peace to you. So tonight is a really special, this is a really special evening. For those of you who are kind of familiar with astrology, you already know that we are actually experiencing the lunar eclipse this evening. The lunar eclipse. And it's a really amazing time to be alive right now. It's a lot of transformative energy that's happening right now. A lot of transformative energy, especially as it relates to value. So your values, and as I titled the video, I titled this live stream, Reevaluating Your Value In, To, and For the Collective. I want to kind of start off by putting us in the mind frame of, I'm pretty sure all of us have seen the movie The Temptations. Well, there's this one scene in the Temptations, because they keep having issues as far as with members of the group having different, struggling with addictions, different addictions. Like, one was an alcoholic, one was, David Ruffin was on cocaine, and then, I forgot the other group member's name that was an alcoholic. But there was this one point where one of the members was just like, well, who is the group for? Who is the group for? You want the group to be, you want everyone in the group to be for the group. And every decision that you say that you're making, as far as cutting these members out, telling these people that, you know what I'm saying, we got to move forward, we got to push forward, we got to keep pushing forward. But who is the group for? That is the exact energy of what is happening right now. Okay, so we have the Sun and Mars, the Sun and Mars are in the second house right now. And we have the Moon in the eighth house. So the Sun and Mars are both in Leo in the second house. And then we have in the eighth house, we have Aquarius. And we are experiencing right now a clash. I guess you could say a clash, because with the lunar eclipse, that would denote like a revolution or a sudden change or powerful, like transformative events happening. So things that are life-changing, things that are game-changing. That's why I said this is a really transformative time, because of the fact that the lunar eclipse is going on. So there can be a lot, especially for Aquariuses right now, there can be a lot of shadow work going on for Aquariuses. So if your sun, moon, or rising sign is in Aquarius right now, you could be experiencing this especially hard, especially difficult for you if you are an Aquarius, finding and understanding how you fit in a collective, and feeling that you are being valued, and feeling that you are being personally validated for what you bring to the equation. So that's if your sun, moon, and rising are in Aquarius. This is gonna be especially hard for you right now. So you really wanna just make sure that you ground yourself during this time if you are sun, moon, or rising are in Aquarius. Now, this can also be hard for you if you're, if you have planets like with strong transits that are in Aquarius on your particular natal chart. Now, that will come into play like when you get a natal reading or something like that. I'm not going into that detail. I would have to actually look at your personal chart to see what planetary transits are happening to find out if anything is happening in Aquarius personally for you. But if I can definitely tell you, if your sun, moon, or rising is Aquarius, then you're feeling this especially hard. Another reason why this lunar eclipse is so powerful is because of the fact that it's taking place in the eighth house. is happening in the house of transformation itself. The eighth house represents transformation all in itself, death. And not just death in like a physical form of dying, but like ideas dying, like things phasing out, like you coming into a new, and when we say death, we know that energy is only recycled. So that naturally means that something else is being reborn. So think about the phoenix, you know, think about, if we want to think about comedic science, we can think about the scarab. We can think about the scarab beetle putting its eggs inside of the dung, and then the baby's coming, you know, popping out. So we know that death is not just saying like, okay, well, this is me that, you know, something tragic is going to happen. No, we got to take the negative connotation that a lot of Western thinking has put in our minds to see death as something negative when it's not. It just means that because energy never dies. So this just means, basically, this is just saying, hey, you know what? Something else is being born here. Something else is being born. So Aquarius, if you are experiencing this, be mindful of the fact that something is trying to be born right now. So the best thing that you can do is to really, again, ground yourself. Really ground yourself in whatever your spiritual practice is, whatever it is that you do to bring you back when things get a little chaotic. So when things start to get chaotic, or when things start to unravel, and I know that can be difficult for Aquarius, because Aquarians typically are, you know, very eccentric people anyway. So these are people who think outside of the box, people who may tend to be loners. But now's the time, Aquarius, if you're going through these transformative changes in your life, it's okay to open up, to have those conversations, to look to your friends, because Aquarius is, you guys are 11th house, that's the house of friends. So it's okay to look to people that you can trust to help guide you through these transformations. And I know it can be especially hard because Aquarius is also a fixed sign. Yes, both Aquarius and Leo are both fixed signs. So when we talk about transformation and something being fixed, so even if you're not familiar with astrology, just think of the word fix. Fix means that something is set in place. That means that something is not easily moved. It's a very persistent thing. It can be quite stubborn. So for Aquarius, is changing and having to deal with change and having to deal with things transforming can be quite uncomfortable. And then that even translates into Leo, because second house and eighth house are opposites of each other. So we have the sun, and we have the sun and Mars in the second house, and then we have in Aquarius down here. And does Aquarius, are there any planets down here? The moon. So the moon is in the eighth house. So we have both of those doing an opposite thing. We got an opposite thing going on right here. So the moon down here and sun and Mars right here. So they're also up in the second house, which is Leo. So we have the sun and Mars in Leo. So we got the sun and Mars, which is fixed in a fixed sign. We got the sun and Mars in a fixed sign. Then we have the moon in a fixed sign. And we're talking transformation. That is just all in itself is it's a lot. It's a lot for a fixed sign. But I want you guys to keep in mind during this time the element of persona versus individuality as well. Because we have Leo, not only are we questioning, are we beginning to understand the transformation that's trying to happen around us. There have been some things, I will say, Aquarius is, and to my Leos as well. So if you're a Leo sun, moon, or rising, or if you're an Aquarius sun, moon, or rising, there have been things that have happened in your life within the past couple weeks, of which you can be a testament to say, you know what I'm saying, that things have been trying to change for me. Things have been trying to get, you know, have been trying to nudge me over into something. Things have been trying to nudge me, and as it relates specifically in the area of persona, persona meaning who, basically who I am, myself. When I'm alone to myself, this is who I really am. Mask off, we think about future, you know, the song Mask Off. So when we take the mask off, who's really up under there? Who's really up under there? So persona, as it relates to leadership as well, because we have Leo in the second house, we have Leo. And then also as it relates to pleasure, things that bring you pleasure have been going head on as far as the transformative. There's been some tension between your persona versus your individuality or the way that you're perceived by society or social persona or friendships or the way that you want people to see you. So there's been some tension, basically, especially for my Leos and Aquariuses. There has been some tension between who you are, the real you, mask off you, versus you that society sees, the social construct sees you as. So if there hasn't been outward tension, there's been inward tension. So Leo's sun moon rising, Aquarius's, it's time to get real right now. This, I believe that this lunar eclipse for you guys is really a wake up call, and it's really telling you to go ahead and make those necessary changes of who to make sure that your persona mask off is the same. So when we're taking both of those masks, it's the same person. Now, of course, you can take the, you know, you can take that attribute of saying, you know, well, I prefer to be this person, you know, behind closed doors, but, and then, you know, out in public, I'm so, it, but the thing about it is there's tension there. There's tension there because this denotes shadow side, because of the fact that the earth basically is casting a shadow on the moon. So basically this denotes a shadow aspect. This denotes a side of our emotions that we're hiding, because the moon represents emotion. So if there's a shadow over the moon, that means that we're putting a shadow over our emotions. So there have been some deep-seated emotional imbalances with my Leos and my Aquariuses as it relates to your value. You've not been feeling fully valued in the collective, or you're trying to find your value in the collective, to the collective. So maybe, you know, you're having that what have you done for me lately mentality or thought in your mind. Maybe a lot of you have been feeling unhappy at work. Maybe a lot of you have been feeling unhappy, you know, in your friendships or relationships because you don't feel valued, or you don't feel as valued as you should, or how you feel that you should be. There's the self, that self aspect of Leo. So you have Leo saying, hey, you know, this is who I am, this is what I bring, and this is in the second house. So we have the sun, which is represented by Leo, and then we have Mars as well in the second house of values. So they're bringing light, and they're bringing attention to how we view ourselves, how we view ourselves as it relates to positions of leadership. Also with pleasure as well, because Leo rules fifth house, which is all about pleasure, the things that we like to do for fun, things that we like to. And there could also be an aspect to my Leos and Aquariuses, there's a fear of the transformation because you're afraid that people are going to judge you for the things that you like to do. So if there is a deep-seated, there's fear there, and you aren't being 100% genuine, or you haven't been 100% genuine in who you are because you don't want to be judged, or you don't want to, you know, lose the favor of that Aquarius aspect of the house of friends. But you're in the eighth house, Aquarius is specifically, you are in the eighth house. You are in the eighth house. That means it's transformation time. Not only is the moon, it's a lunar eclipse in the eighth house. It's like change or or bust. You know what I'm saying? For Aquarius is right now, it's like accept change, accept transformation, as it relates to your values, as it relates to your values. What is valuable to you? Have you been reaping the benefit of everything that you've been putting into the house of friends? Have you been reaping the benefit, the full benefit of whatever you've been putting in? So again, I go back to that first example for those that just tuned in from the movie The Temptations, that the scene where I think his name is Eddie, where he told Otis, he was like, yeah, you know, who is the group for? Who is the group for? You want us to be for, you want us to be all about the group, but who is the group for? So a lot of you guys have been feeling that. Sun, Moon, and Rising Leo. Sun, Moon, and Rising Aquarius. And now is the time for you to decide. Am I going to stay in this situation? Am I going to stay in this job? Am I going to stay in this marriage? Am I going to stay in this friendship? Am I going to stay in this career? Am I going to stay in this this contract? Whatever it is, am I going to stay here if I feel that I'm not being fully valued, and but I'm putting all of my energy, all of my innovation, because Aquarius is all about innovation. I'm putting all of my creativity and all my innovation and all my quirks and all of this into, you know, this second house thing that's supposed to be bringing me value, but I'm not seeing the residual, because again, this is shadow work. So it's saying that, okay, am I fully, you know, maybe there's some emotions I've been holding back because I haven't felt fully fulfilled in it. So now's the time for you to go ahead and get on that. So revolution, sudden changes, powerful transformative events in life. This can be a game changer for you, Aquarius and Leo, specifically for you guys, for us, because I am a lunar Leo, so this affects me too. I've been feeling it too. I've been feeling it all up in here, y'all. I've been feeling it all up in here. Just reevaluating what is value to me, you know. I really literally had to have a conversation with myself on what was valuable to me, because I began to feel less than. But then I was just like, hey, you know what I'm saying? Let me reevaluate some things. So I recommend the same to you. Okay, so now I'm going to go into the different houses. No, I couldn't catch all the comments. I saw somebody was asking about Gemini. I haven't gotten into the house placements and what planets are doing what. So I'm about to get into that now. So let's start with the first house. So right now, and again, if you would like a personal, if you would like for your personal natal chart to be read either from birth, or if you would like for me to read your chart and do the astrology for that particular month, just holler at me and let me know, and I can definitely do that to dissect the transits and see what is going on for you personally. All right, but this is just a general. This is just a general. So this is discussing the actual planetary placements, not necessarily the transits. So if you would like to know about the transits, just holler. Okay. So first house. Right now, Mercury is in the first house, and it's about to head into retrograde on August 12th. It'll be going into Virgo. So right now, Mercury, during this lunar eclipse, Mercury is in the first house. It'll be heading retrograde August 12th in Virgo. So Virgos, ding ding ding, all my Virgos out there, hey guys. Okay, so Mercury is about to be going retrograde. Specifically for you, it's going to be kind of like a direct effect for you. So, of course, it's going to affect everybody. But Virgos, be really vigilant. Even though it's not retrograde, it's starting to slow down. So that means that you're going to start to feel the effects. Even before the 12th, you begin to feel the effects. And for Virgo, that can be really tedious, because Virgos tend to be a little OCD. They want to dot all the I's and cross all the T's. And Virgos do not like for things to be out of place. Virgos want things to be planned and executed to a T. They want it to run smoothly, because that decreases anxiety for a Virgo. So, guys, the best thing I can tell you right now is to be prepared, to prepare yourself to be, as we roll into August, as it gets closer to the 12th, make sure that any important meetings that you have, any important documents, make sure that you save your documents on a USB as well. Don't just, you know, depend on Word or something like that. Save it on a USB. Take extra precautions because of the fact that Mercury is going retrograde. Mercury is the planet that rules, in astrology rules, communication. So communication systems, networks, different things like that are prone to break down during that time. So that's internet, that is, that deals with vehicles, that deals with phones, that deals with any type of communication. It can be, it can also be communications as well as machinery. So it can also be things that's related maybe to, maybe at your job, if you have some type of a system that, you know, that runs all the, a computer that runs the whole system, it may break down. It may be more prone to break down during that time. So take the necessary precautions. If you have Virgos, if you have anything big coming up that relates to something depending on you having a document or some type of digital equipment, a camera or something like that, be vigilant during that time going into it. So I would save things more than once in more than one place. If you have an important speech, if you have an important, like I said, file or something like that, save it. Make sure you save it. Take the precautions that you can take in advance. So yes, and it will be happening on August 12th again. So about mid-month. Second house, which was, I was telling you guys about, Mars and the Sun are both in Leo in the second house, the house of value. So for you guys, I have, actually it'll be going into, the Sun will be going into Virgo, of course, September 5th. So, for that second house of value, definitely Leo's right now. Now's the time for you to be taking action as it relates to, your value system. The Sun, which is, exalted in Leo because it's ruling, Leo is, it's ruling, the Sun is Leo's ruling planet. I'm sorry. So right now is the time for you to especially be taking action, as it relates to things of value for you. I'm talking about material value. It's a good time for you to be looking into investments. It's a good time for you to be looking into maybe asking for a raise at your job. The energy is ripe for you to receive. Or if you're looking for another job, or if you're looking for, now's the time for you to push for. So maybe Leos, if you've been kind of feeling jet lagged, maybe you've been feeling kind of down, depressed, kind of sad, not feeling your most powerful, as Leos like to feel, you know, like the boss. If you haven't been feeling that way, now's the time. You have Mars in Leo in the second house along with the Sun, which is a benefic thing. That is so benefic for Leos. That is so benefic for you to have the Sun in the second house. So Leos, now is the time for go for what you know as far as it relates to finances and things of value to you. So if that's a new career, if that's a new job, if that's a new car, if that's a new any type of material possession that's going to bring about more, I guess you could say, status, or to improve your quality of life at this point in time, Leo, now is a great time to go ahead and do it. It's giving you the oomph. The universe is giving you the oomph to go ahead and do it. You get Mars right there with the Sun. So go ahead. If you had kind of slacked off on your job search, keep putting in those applications. Keep going. So let Leos be encouraged. This is a really, really, really great energy for you guys. Leos, be encouraged. I just want to continue to encourage you because you have such a great thing happening. And then not only that, but you have opposite the second house you have right down here in the eighth house of transformation. Hi, this is the eighth house of transformation. Right down here you have the Moon with the lunar eclipse. Such a powerful aspect right down there opposite of the Sun and Mars both in the second house of value. So come on, this is a time that can be a game-changing time for Leo. Leo, if you go for it, if you do not give up, if you keep that strong heart, because Leo represents the heart, it represents courage. If you keep your heart strong during this time, keep yourself encouraged, keep yourself around people who are encouraging you and who are pushing you forward to go ahead and go for what you know. So it will be again, the sun will be in Leo until September 5th when it goes into Virgo. So keep going, Leos. Let me just encourage you once again. Just keep going. You have a lot of great things, a lot of great aspects happening for you right now. The energy is ripe. All right. So next, third house, we have Venus. Venus is in the third house. It will be going into, it's in the third house in Cancer. So that's a really great thing to all my Cancers right now. I would definitely say right now to be thinking about things that will add to as far as it relates to things that you, maybe to the Cancers out there, maybe you guys have been feeling a bit, I don't want to say blah, because that's not really a good word to describe. Okay, maybe you haven't been feeling so beautiful. Maybe you haven't been feeling so charming. Maybe you haven't been feeling so, you know, pizzazz. Is that a word? Pizzazzy? I don't know. But anyway, so Cancers, now is the time for you really to be putting the love back in your life, or finding the love in not only the way that you communicate with other people, but even the way that you just, I don't know, I guess you could say, I'm trying to give you guys a common example. Maybe for Cancers, you guys have been feeling as though you kind of have been getting lost. And a lot of the things that you're doing as it relates to maybe broadcasting yourself, or maybe the way that the world sees you as it relates to your dealings with, I guess I would say social media, maybe the way that you've been looking at yourself, maybe the way that you've been, you haven't been feeling as charming. I don't know why that keeps coming back to me. Just, you haven't been feeling charming, Cancers. You haven't been feeling your oomph and your, I got this, you know, I'm, you know, like, so I guess for you guys, it's really just, I'm trying to make it really complicated and extensive and all that, but it's really simple. You just need to find the love again. You know what I'm saying? After the love is gone, what? How could you leave? So you guys need to get that earth, wind, and fire. You know what I'm saying? Play you some earth, wind, and fire, and find that love again. So if you have lost that love, Cancer, if you have lost that love as it relates to maybe your passion, not even, when I say social media, it's just an easy way to relate to digital communication. It's such an easy way because it's like everybody is doing social media now. So, Cancer, so if you have been, you know, kind of not feeling, you know, as, you know, do something fun, do something different, do you a sexy little photo shoot or something like that, you know what I'm saying? Take you some pictures and have fun, you know what I'm saying? Have fun. And, maybe Cancers, for a lot of you guys, I'm feeling that maybe you've been wanting to go on the deeper end as far as it goes with communication, when maybe you just need to do some things that are just more fun and free with your communication. Maybe, you know, cute, you know, sexy, handsome, to all my men that are Cancers, something fun, flirty, sexy, handsome, to all my men who are Cancers out there, as it relates to how we view you from digital means. So, maybe you guys have been kind of on the serious side, so it's time to lively up. Maybe that's why it took me so long to kind of get that out. I was looking for a really dynamic, powerful way to say it, but it's something simple. Like, really, just kind of lighten up and, you know, do something fun, as it relates to, your third house ambition. So, if it can be any type of communication, you know, like, It can be anything that's related to just regular day-to-day banter. It's okay to have that conversation and, you know, have fun with your friends and talk about stuff that's not, you know, Insecure came on. Girl, let's talk about, girl, did you see Insecure? Did you see, bruh, did you watch Power? You know what I'm saying? Like, it's okay, Cancer. It's okay. Maybe you guys have been kind of on a, like, a searching for deeper, you know, like, ninth house, you know, like, deeper spiritual meanings. It's okay. This is time for you. It's fine for you to do that. It's cool. Yes. Okay. So, fourth house, you guys, okay, Gemini, this is happening in, the lunar eclipse is happening in the fourth house for you guys. There aren't any planets there, but definitely with you guys being fourth house, definitely Gemini, this is the time for you to really, 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 really be looking at the time that you are spending with your family. This is family time, Gemini. Family time. It's all about family. That's the best thing I could tell you at this point. So transformative energy for how you're viewing your family. What's going on at home, Gemini? Are there some things that, as far as it relates to how your family life is looking or how it's been going? You know, so Gemini, this is that time. This is time for you to look homeward. And also at, you know, karmic connections. So friendships that aren't just, you know, just day-to-day friendships, deep friendships. So maybe some people that maybe you consider family who may need you during this time. So Gemini, the best thing I can tell you guys during this energy is to look homeward. Look homeward. All right. So Taurus, it's in the fifth house for you. This is happening fifth house for you guys. So Taurus, fifth house, pleasure. Hey, this is how we do it. This is how we do it. Okay, so Taurus, like, fifth house is always fun. Fifth house is always fun. So Taurus, right now you don't have any planets going on during this energy. However, because of the fact that this lunar eclipse is happening in the fifth house for you, I would say definitely, and then also Mercury will be going retrograde in your fifth house. I would say, Taurus, that you guys also need to not only be looking at that aspect of what your place of value in the group, or your place of value amongst friends or society. So reevaluating that as it relates to things that bring you pleasure, Taurus. Reevaluating your place in the group or in society, or your ties to society or your friends as it relates to things that bring you pleasure. So maybe there's some things that you like to do. Maybe there are some hobbies that you have, Taurus, that you really haven't really felt like you are receiving, like, enough, you know, well, I like to do this, but I don't receive any validation from doing this, or I don't feel really, you're looking for external validation versus internal validation, Taurus. So if you've been seeking external why can't I say this word right now? If you've been seeking external, you need to come back in. If you've been seeking external, come back in, Taurus. Come back in. Bring all of that back inside and validate thyself. Amani say validate thyself, Taurus. So whatever it is that you, you have been seeking external value from the group as far as it relates to things that you like to do, because remember, fifth house is pleasure and hobbies of the person themselves, not necessarily the group. So if you've been seeking external validation for whatever it is that you enjoy doing, the hobbies that you enjoy having, the people that you like to date, because it's also lovers, so the people that you like to date, if you've been seeking external validation, it's time to come back in. Okay. So sixth house, is happening, in the sixth house. Uranus is in retrograde in Aries. So Aries, Right now, okay, so with Uranus being in retrograde in the sixth house, that can be kind of difficult. That can be kind of difficult because of the fact that Uranus represents transformation and is retrograde in Aries in the sixth house. So that means that instead of with Aries, you may feel like right now that your transformative energy may be moving backwards. It's not even moving forward in your mind. You've been feeling as if your transformative power, your ability has been working against you. And how it's really been affecting you the most negatively is in your mundane tasks. So maybe if you have a nine to five job or something that you do that isn't necessarily something that you're passionate in, Aries, but it's just something that you do to keep, you know, the bills paid, keep the lights on, keep the everything like that to keep your family stable. Maybe you've been trying to change some things about the way that you operate, and you've been trying to do that. However, you've been meeting a lot of resistance because Uranus represents transformation, but it's retrograde, which means it's moving backwards. Aries, maybe you've been going into a recession. Maybe you've been digressing, Aries. Make sure you're not moving backwards as well. Make sure you're not going back into the same places that you climb tooth and nail to get out of, Aries, but you reach the level of comfort and, you know, now it's kind of like a stalemate. Now you're not really seeing that progress that you really want to see because of the fact that, you know, you got a little too comfortable. So with Uranus, your transformation power being retrograde in Aries in the sixth house of mundane tasks, and health as well. Health. So during this time, Aries, you really need to be taking transformative, like super transformative action as it relates to your health, the health of your body, your physical body. So even if you don't feel like working out, go work out. If you don't feel like eating healthy, eat healthy. You know, it's right now it's going to be a mind over matter type thing for you. Just be strong. Again, my advice to anybody that is going through anything like that is to stay grounded. Stay grounded in your practice. Practice, practice, practice. So you're chanting, you're meditating, your prayer, you're fasting, whatever it is that you do that keeps you, keeps a clear connection between you and source. Stay on it. All right, so seventh house, right now in the seventh house is happening. So Pisces, you guys have Neptune. Now this is a benefic, even though Neptune is retrograde, Pisces, check this out. Even though Neptune is retrograde, that is still your ruling planet. So that is a benefic aspect for you. You still have the power of the Neptune energy, Neptunian energy, as an assistant to you. Now, mind you, Neptune is moving backwards, though. So you also, Pisces, may feel like you're moving backwards as it relates to your dreams actually becoming a fruition, or maybe your dreams have been working against you. Maybe you've been extra intuitive to the point where you haven't really even understood what these dreams are about. Why are you having these dreams? What is this? These dreams are these thoughts. They don't have to necessarily be dreams when you're asleep. They could be daydreams, these thoughts that keep coming in your head. And you're just like, why do I keep thinking this? Why do I keep feeling this way? Why? And you're not in control of those thoughts. They're just coming to you. So maybe it feels like they're moving against you. Maybe it feels like, you know, those daydreams or those dreams have been actually working against you. But be mindful of the fact, this is how you take your power back, Pisces, is by understanding that intuitive nature, those dreams, those daydreams, all of that, the intuition that you have, all of it comes with purpose. It is up to you to fine tune it. It is up to you to fine tune your intuition to where it becomes a tool and not something to, you know, destroy you. It builds you. So you must find your path, and that path, again, I keep going back to being grounded. You have to be spiritually grounded. You have to. There's no ifs, ands, or buts. You have to be grounded in order to use that intuition and use your dreams and use that Neptunian energy as a tool. If not, Neptune will continue to go backwards, and you will continue to feel more aloof, and you will continue to feel more dazed, and you will continue to want to escape Pisces and use escapism and detach from your loved ones and your friends and your family and really from reality, because of the fact that you don't want to deal with the things that are going on. You want to escape into the dream world because, you know, the reality of your life at this point may not be something that you're ready to fully deal with. So, and Pisces, this is a deep lesson for you guys, because Neptune is retrograde in Pisces until November 21st. So you guys are going to be here for a while. You're going to be dealing with that Neptune retrograde energy for a while. And I know you guys, just like with Saturn being retrograde in Sagittarius, my sun sign, I've been dealing with that, you know, and it's a long transit, you know what I'm saying? It's a long period. These are slower moving planets, so it's going to take them a longer time to, you know, actually go direct. So that just means during this time there's something that the universe really wants us to get with these slower moving planets. And then the thing about the slower moving planets is that most of them represent, if not all of the slower moving planets, represent internal reflection. They're not external things. They're internal. They're mostly in inner work. And then check this out, y'all. This is really cool. So to my Pisces, you also have Chiron retrograde in Pisces till, guess when? December 4th. Why is that so bomb diggy to me? Because y'all know December 4th is Jay-Z's birthday, right? Ha! Your girl caught that. 444. His birthday is December 4th. He released 444 on the day of the Chiron retrograde. And it goes direct on his birthday, December 4th. So shout out to Jay-Z being like on this science, like for real. Just shout out to the brother. But anyway, so Chiron retrograde is gonna be retrograde in Pisces until December 4th. So Pisces, not only are you dealing with moving backwards, or a feeling of moving backwards as it relates to your dreams, although really that's your power because of the fact that Neptune is your ruling planet. If you guys can master that, Pisces, y'all gonna be on some next level stuff, like real talk. And I believe in you. I believe in you, Pisces, that you can master this. But if, you know, if and when you master your dreams, if and when you master your intuitiveness, if and when you master, you know, that heightened sensitivity that you guys have to things that aren't necessarily just, you know, face value. Once you're going to be on some next level stuff. But you're also dealing with Chiron retrograde. So Chiron basically is like karmic lessons, karmic lessons. Yes. It's the wounded healer. So things that you have come back here to learn. So the wounded healer, things that you have learned through battle, things that you've learned through different battles that you fought in your life, hard wins. So they can either, now on the positive end, Chiron can represent hard wins, but on the negative end, when we're talking about moving backwards, we're focusing more on, you know, the trauma of our past that it becomes paranoia about the future. You focus so much on the trauma of your past that it becomes your complete focus, and it builds up a paranoia of the possibility of the future. So Pisces, if you've been feeling, you know, a sense of paranoia about, you know, well, I kind of want to date, but I'm afraid because of the fact that my last girlfriend, you know, cheated on me. I kind of want to date, but I'm kind of afraid because my last boyfriend, you know, was abusive to me. I kind of want to get a new job, but I'm kind of scared because the last time I put in an application, you know, it didn't work out for me. So, you know, not really being able to move forward because you're so focused on the wounds. You're not focused on the healing. You went through the wounds. You went through those things to learn a lesson. You know, they were there to teach you. They're your teachers. They're not your torturers. They're your teachers. So, you know, look at those lessons, Pisces. Be especially mindful to be looking at them as teachers and not as torturers. So, and, you know, this is another long haul for Pisces. You guys are really going to earn your stripes. You're really going to, the universe is really making y'all earn your stripes. Because that will be retrograde until December 4th. Jay-Z's birthday. Hey, you heard it here first. I haven't heard any other astrology break that down. But as far as the, you know, the 444. But anyway, so if y'all hear it again, y'all know who said it first. But anyway, yes, so 8th house is happening. This is where the lunar eclipse is happening, in the 8th house in Aquarius. Okay, so Aquarius is like, y'all, universe is really talking to you guys about transforming. It's time. It's time for you to level up. It's time for Aquarius is to really... to let go. It's a shedding going on right now for Aquarius. This is a shedding. This is a big, like, there's a regenerative, there is a new, because I don't want to pronounce it. There is a newness. There is a newness. There's a new energy that's really trying to, there's a baby that's trying to crown for you, Aquarius. That's the best way I can describe it. There is a baby that is trying to crown, but Aquarius, you guys are really, really, struggling because of the fact that this lunar eclipse is happening. It's not a full moon, so it's not the manifestation of, no, this is shadow. This is casting a shadow on. So this means that for Aquarius, you guys have really been struggling with that transformation. Something is trying to change in your life. Something for the better, guys. You got to trust. That's the thing about it. You have to trust that this change that you're coming up on is going to be for the better. And it will. It will be something that's going to change your life and put you in a positive direction. It's not here to harm you. This change, you guys, really, Aquarius, really stop fearing changes. Stop fearing changes. I know you guys are a fixed sign, but you're really going to have to pull in from any other mutable aspect that you may have in your personal, natal chart, whatever other mutable signs that you have, you're going to have to pull in from those, Aquarius. You're going to have to, because of the fact that with a fixed sign, sometimes it's almost never that, you know, fixed signs are able to adapt. You know what I'm saying? That's not saying that you just change and change, 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 change. But when it's time to change, which it is right now for you, Aquarius, it's time for change. It's time for you to transform. It's time for you to phase out. There are some things that, and you know this, you don't have to share them. You don't even have to share them with me. You know this. There's some things that the universe has been trying to phase out your life for a while now. And it's probably been really, really heavy leading up to this lunar eclipse. So you've been feeling it, especially more heavy leading up to the lunar eclipse. And then tonight, this is a culmination. So maybe your feelings are over the past couple weeks have been like, you know. But of course, because you are a fixed sign, you know, you're fighting the funk. You're fighting the funk. So you have to let go and you have to allow that transformation during this time. And then your emotions. So maybe, Aquarius, you've been feeling, because of the fact that, now when we talk about shadow work, when it comes to, when we're talking about the shadow aspect of the moon, this can also heighten like darker emotions as well. So it can go from, you know, just being I don't want this to happen. It can easily morph into things like you know, feeding off of your pain, off of, or off of your grief, off of past trauma. It can turn into paranoia as well with you guys if it's not, you know, addressed and understood that these emotions that I'm feeling right now, it's because of the fact that that's that crown, that's the baby's head crowning. I'm feeling these emotions because of the fact that it's time for me to go ahead and level up. It's time for me to level up. So feel these emotions, embrace these emotions, whatever you've been feeling, Aquarius, as it relates to your transformation, eighth house, death. Some things have got to die. Some things have got to die in order for this new baby to be born in and from you. So moving on, ninth house. All right, so Pluto is retrograde in Capricorn. So Capricorns, you guys are going to be feeling this Pluto retrograde. So maybe you guys have been not been feeling, because Pluto represents power, ambition, and vigor. So maybe you guys have been feeling as if you've been, instead of powering up, you kind of been powering down, as it relates to, maybe you haven't been feeling as powerful as it relates to maybe your spiritual life or your pursuits in higher education, or your pursuits in, if you have any legal issues going on right now. Maybe you've been feeling, Capricorns, if you haven't been feeling as fulfilled in the way that you, the things are at face value. You've been looking for deeper meanings in things, but you haven't been feeling as fulfilled in what you've been finding. So maybe you guys are kind of at a phase right now, Capricorns, where you're kind of upset. You're questioning a lot right now. You're really questioning a lot about, you know, as it relates to the higher knowledge, and the way that you're looking at higher knowledge, or how you're acquiring higher knowledge, or where you're getting higher knowledge from. Maybe you haven't been feeling as though it has really been powering you the way that, you know, you need to be powered right now. So that for you, Capricorn, means guess what? You got to go on a journey, Capricorn. You got to put your Timberlands on and go on a journey and search for the deeper meaning. You know, if you haven't been getting fed off of what you've been eating, yet you still continue to eat the same things, you still continue to consume the same information, but you know good and well on the inside that information is not really fulfilling you, it's time for you to put those, lace those Timberland boots up and go on a journey in the ninth house. Ninth house is all about journey. So it can be higher education, Capricorns, maybe some of you, even if it's not on a spiritual level, maybe it's just on a material level. You're not happy with your material setup. So you know, have been thinking about going back to school or getting your degree or getting some type of certification. Go for it. Energy is saying go. This is not the energy of you guys focus on the house, or, you know, focus on your home, or focus on mundane tasks. No, this focus right now for Capricorn is saying go for the higher knowledge that's going to get you to the next level. So it can be career wise, getting additional certifications, going back to school, or even on a spiritual level, Capricorns, if you have not been feeling fulfilled in what you've been consuming on an information as level, as far as it relates to your spiritual path, because ninth house is also spirituality and religion, it's time for you to lace your boots up and seek and you will find. All right, so moving on to the 10th house, Sagittarius, man, this is happening. The lunar eclipse is happening for us in the 10th house of careers, which is good, but you know, we got Saturn over there in retrograde. Oh, Sagittarius, I know, bruh. I know. I feel your pain. But yeah, we got Saturn in retrograde. But we're coming out of our retrograde. Saturn is coming out on August the 24th. Woohoo! So Sagittarius, Sun, Moon, or Rising. So Saturn is coming out of the retrograde. However, during this Saturn retrograde period, and this is in the 10th house of careers, careers and status, the universe is going to be asking us, what did we learn during this retrograde, this Saturn retrograde period? What did we learn? What did we learn about discipline? What did we learn about, you know, routine and structure? What did we learn? What wisdom did we gain? What wisdom did we gain during this retrograde period? During Sagittarius is out there, Sun, Moon, or Rising. What have you learned over the past month? What lessons have been thrown your way? So not negative, not looking at them as negative things, but what lessons have been thrown your way? What little, you know, monkey wrenches did the universe throw out there in your life over the past month? Be thinking about that. Because as Saturn begins to go direct, because it'll be direct on August the 24th. So when it heads direct, that's saying that we should have learned something. And especially because of the fact that it's in our 10th house of careers, we really need to be, Sagittarius really needs to be focusing on the direction of your career. What is it that you want to do? What is it that you want to do? What have you learned from the things that you've been doing as it relates to what you want to do? What direction are you taking to get you towards where you want to be? But really garnering from lessons that we learn. So the universe really wants us to get our hands dirty, reach down in the dirt and everything. Because when Saturn represents that wisdom, it represents discipline, like lessons learned. So if it's moving backwards, that means that it would be like immaturity. It would be like not making wise choices, not really, you know, learning from past mistakes as it relates to wisdom, things that we should know. Like, fool me once, shame on you. Fool me twice, shame on me. So if there are some things, repetitive things, not just new, you know, okay, well, you know, this is just, this happened, you know. But it's not a first. No, wisdom means that this is something that has happened before. So as it relates to career-wise, what has happened before? What has happened before? What has worked before? What didn't work before? What can I take with me on this journey? What do I need to leave behind on this journey? Who do I need to take with me on this journey? Who do I need to leave behind? So Sagittarius, as it refers to us, with this transformative energy of the lunar eclipse being in the 8th house, this is a time where we really need to be, because if we do this right, if we roll these dice the right way, this can mean that transformative energy spilling over into our 10th house of careers, spilling over into our 10th house of not only careers, but status and power as well. So really learning, Sagittarius, make sure you're learning from the lessons of the past as it relates to your career efforts and your career identity. Okay, moving on, 11th house. So right now, this is Scorpio. Scorpio, there aren't any planets there in the 11th house, but right now that with this lunar eclipse happening and happening for you in the 11th house, now is just a really good time for you guys to really be looking at transformative relationships with people, transformative partnerships, transformative connections with people. So really be looking, Scorpios, into partnerships with people that can really transform the way that you operate on a personal level. It can be on a business level, it can be whatever, but you know, when we say the house of friends and organizations, it can be, you know, friends can be a really fun thing to have. Like, oh, I got friends, you know, we go out on the weekends and we have fun. Or friends, as you begin to mature, you know, you have friends that, you know, that you, that may actually be in business with you. So however you want to link that up, however that works for you, maybe now's the time, Scorpio, for you to be phasing out of some friendships or social ties with people that are no longer in the direction of where you want to go. So really transformative in the way that you're viewing your friendships. Maybe now's the time for you to be looking at more professional relationships or professional organizations, professional ties, Scorpio, and getting out of, you know, so much the, you know, well, just the turn up, you know what I'm saying? Going out to turn up. Like, it's really fun to go out and handle business at the same time. Like, that's kind of, it's fun. Take it from somebody that, like, never had done that before. And then I went out and I was like, oh, wow. So I killed two birds with one stone. And I had a great time. So, yeah. So, Scorpios, really be looking into that. Transformative partnerships. Transformative relationships. People who can build you. Being around people who, you know, maybe their net worth is more than you. People you can learn from, Scorpio. People you can study. People who don't mind sharing information with you. On whatever level, you know what I'm saying? Not necessarily saying that they you have to tell you all the secrets to the back cave, but just enough for you to, you know, be industrious enough for you to go and, you know, take what you learn and build on that and build on that. Because, you know, of course, Scorpio, you know, you guys definitely have that passion, you know what I'm saying? You do have that passion and you love really hard, you hate really hard. So really just not looking at those partnerships on a personal level or taking anything personally, but just taking the good from it, Scorpio. Just really taking the good from it. Choosing to have a perception to where, you know what, I'm going to take the good from anything that the universe brings my way. Any friendship, any partnership, any, you know, organization, I'm just going to take the good from it and, you know, what it, the rest of it can go to the side. I'm not really worried about it. So that's my best advice for you guys during this transformative lunar eclipse energy. And then last but not least, Libra. Libra, guys, you guys have Jupiter in Libra. Jupiter is in Libra in the 12th house. So, so creative and expansive 12th house energy. So, Libras, you guys have really been having a lot of creative dreams. You guys have been having a lot of creative visions. You guys have been having a lot of creative thoughts, ways, been thinking up, kind of cooking up in the kitchen of your minds how you can transform yourself or your business or your brand or your, you know, your job or, you know, your home, your spouse, your children. You've been having a lot of different creative internal. So really now's the time for you to really even be cranking up and writing down. This is the time for Libra to be writing down these visions that you guys, because with the fact that the lunar eclipse is going on in the 8th house, that's going to mean that those dreams and visions and thoughts are even more powerful or even more pronounced during this time. So, and then with Libra being the sign of collaboration, maybe it's a good idea for you to, as far as it relates to that 12th house energy, which would typically be a more internal, maybe it's a good idea for you to maybe talk to maybe just one or two people that you know that you trust about some of the things that you have or ideas that you have, or maybe there's some people who can, you know, kind of help you or assist you to kind of cultivate those ideas, Libra. So really getting out of the mode of being indecisive and should I, will I do this or will I? And then another reason I say to tell someone or someone that you trust or maybe a relative or something like that, it doesn't have to be 10 people, just one person. It's because there's a level of accountability, because I know with 12th house, sometimes we can get lost in the 12th house and it can be just completely internal. My mind. But instead of it actually spreading out and becoming, you know, like, okay, from my mind to manifestation. So it's good to talk to people sometimes, because then therein lies the accountability. Who's going to hold me accountable to making this happen? So Libra, I would definitely say write down your visions, write down your, because dreams are going to be really pronounced for you during this time. So write everything down and create a plan and give yourself a deadline. You may talk to a trusted friend about it. And just give yourself a deadline to actually get it done. Make it happen. Make it happen. All right, so that is everybody's aspect. That is everybody's aspects as far as where the planets, the planetary aspects are during this lunar eclipse. Of course, there are transitory different things that are going on. And if you would like, again, if you would like for me to kind of give you a rundown of how it will look for you throughout the month of August, just holler at me. You can send me a direct message. Or if you know me personally, you can just call me or text me. And I can definitely break everything down for you. But I hope you guys have an awesome lunar eclipse experience. Tap into this transformative energy. And the affirmation for tonight is just going to be deal with your value. Understand your value. Understand where you are and how you bring value to the collective, and deal with it. Don't run from it. It's time to transform. If you haven't been feeling like you've been getting the value you deserve from whatever partnership that you're in right now, it's time for you to pull that Leo out. The sun is in Leo and so is Mars. It's time for you to take action and say, you know what, will I bring this to the table? I feel like I deserve this. Okay, the group wants me to be for the group, but who is the group for at the end of the day? That's your line in the sand. Draw your line in the sand and stand firm. All right, well, I will talk to y'all later. Peace.